It's definitely pool season, but before you head out there with the kiddos, there are some things you need to think about. With us this morning, we have Erica Brennes. Her blog is Real Mom, Real Tired. I hope you're not too tired to come in this morning.
I feel like I just function tired. You live tired. You try to get sleep when you can.
Yeah.
But yeah, Real Mom, Real Tired. It's just my blog name and having fun with it and sharing tips and
Doing all the mom things. That's why we love having you here this morning, because the pool time, it can be a little hectic, and this is coming from somebody who doesn't have any children.
Yeah, I know. Well, you see it. Like, you're at the pool, and there's kids, and they're just running everywhere. So, yeah, I kind of want to just put some items together that I take to the pool that kind of helps make things go a little bit smoother.
Yeah. Let's talk first, though, about just safety at the pool, because it is important to have a certain amount of parents there to keep an eye on all the kids.
I know, and so I kind of have a strategy, just personally, of one-to-one. So one parent pays attention to the kid. We just have one kid.
Yeah.
So we just designate, like, who is watching the baby, because sometimes almost when there's more people, that's sort of when someone just assumes someone else is watching the baby and when things can get tricky. And one of the rules we have is just no phone.
Yeah.
So no phone in the pool. I say dump the distractions, because we are always looking down on our phones, and you got to always have an eye on the baby.
Okay, you brought a lot of amazing items. So let's talk a little bit about some of these.
Okay, so let's talk swim diapers.
Yes.
So at pretty much every public pool, at least that I've been to, you got to have two. So I brought the reusable swim diapers because I like those the best. And we talk about, you got to wear the first one, kind of keeps in the number one, and number two keeps in the number two. So that's why you have to have two swim diapers. You definitely don't want to be the parent that only shows up with one swim diaper and then you have an accident, because then the pool has to close down for the whole day, and no one wants to be that mom.
Definitely.
Yeah. And then these fun floats.
They're so fun.
You like this one.
I wish this was an adult size.
Right?
It has a little hood and everything.
Yeah. So this is a baby shark.
Yeah.
Which my daughter is obsessed with baby shark. So it's a shark float. And then, the baby sits in there, which you still need to supervise the baby in the float, but then it has this cover to kind of shade the baby.
Yeah,
we're using this little puddle jumper whale floaty right now. Mm-hmm. But so let's talk a little bit about shade and sunscreen,
the right bathing suit.
Yeah, and then a hat. I mean, if they'll keep it on, I would just recommend like a waterproof hat, and then one that has like this stiffer brim, mm-hmm. so it can really shade the baby. And then a lot of parents know the struggle is real on the like sunscreen, like battle to get your kid to wear sunscreen. So I found this super fun, sparkly sunscreen. So I'm like, I feel like actually adults might like the glitter sunscreen.
It's more like an arts and crafts thing, right?
I know, and these are a couple others.
Okay. Yeah, and we also have these water shoes.
Yeah, the water shoes, because the pool can get slippery, and sometimes it's rough on the bottom, so I highly recommend water shoes, and I brought some sparkly ones too, and then some cute little easy slip-ons. But yeah, if you do have that sunscreen battle, a long sleeve bathing suit is the way to go, because it also saves some money.
And if people want to get a hold of you and keep up with your blog, how can they do that?
So realmomrealtired.com.
Thank you so much for coming in, Erica.
Thanks, Tanya. Thanks for having me.